Hello guys, this is me, Dr. Kashan Kasi. Today here we were discussing about the ECG. In previous lecture we have discussed about the ST segment and the causes for the ST segment elevation, which is the abnormality of ST segment. Today we are going to discuss another part of the previous lecture, which is ST segment depression. In ST segment depression, we will discuss the clinical condition in which you will notice the ST segment depression in the ECG paper. So today we are going to discuss about the ST segment depression. But before going to discuss about today's lecture, I must say here, go and click on that bell icon and subscribe and share my channel to your friends and colleagues so that you will get my notification for next videos. So let's come toward the today's topic, which is ST segment depression. The ST segment is a portion of the ECG complex, which is the straight isoelectric line. Here, this is shown here. This is the isoelectric line straight, which start at the end of this S wave and it ends here at the beginning of T wave. So it is a portion of the ECG complex, which is a straight portion, and it is between the ventricular depolarization and ventricular repolarization. It is actually the interval between ventricular depolarization and ventricular repolarization. So coming towards its shape, it can be upsloping, downsloping, and horizontal. Talking about the downsloping and horizontal ST segment, you will notice that ST segment depression, when it is greater than or equal to 0.5 mm at J point, then you will say that it is significant ST segment depression. And you can see that the patient is having the condition like MI, or there can also be condition like unstable angina or any of these condition. So the significant ST segment depression will be considered only when it is greater than 0.5 mm at J point, and it is usually seen in more than or equal to 2 contiguous leads. So now we are going to discuss about the causes of ST segment depression. The causes of ST segment depression involves here the IHDs, ischemic heart diseases, which involve number one here, the non-ST segment elevated MI. Then comes the unstable angina, and these are all the conditions in which you will notice the ST segment depression. Like we have discussed in acute coronary syndromes like ST segment elevated MI, you will notice the ST segment elevation on a ECG paper. Likewise, in non-ST elevated MI, you will notice the ST segment depression, and also in unstable angina, you will notice the ST segment depression. I will show here the difference between unstable angina and non-ST segment elevated MI. A patient comes to you with a chest pain, how will you differentiate between these two? That is unstable angina and non-ST elevated MI. Both these are the forms of acute coronary syndrome. There is another third form, which is STEMI, ST elevated MI of this acute coronary syndrome. So the difference between unstable angina and non-ST elevated MI is that in both conditions you will notice the ST segment depression. But in unstable angina, cardiac biomarkers will be negative, while in NSTEMI, you will notice the positive cardiac biomarkers. So this is how you will differentiate between these two, unstable angina and NSTEMI. Next comes here the ventricular hypertrophy with strain. In ventricular hypertrophy with strain, you will definitely see the ST segment depression on a ECG paper, but there will be also T wave inversions seen on a ECG paper. Then comes the digoxin toxicity. In digoxin toxicity, this is usually seen in a patient who are taking this drug, which is digoxin, like in chronic heart failure patient and also in atrial fibrillation. In both these conditions, you will notice the ST segment depression, and this ST segment depression will be in the shape of reverse tick sign or thumb impression. These are the signs you will notice in digoxin toxicity. Then comes another condition, which is acute posterior wall MI. In posterior wall MI, you will notice the ST segment depression, and there will be also dominant R wave on a ECG paper. I will show here the ECG of posterior wall MI. When a patient comes to you with a chest pain, you will notice on ECG that when the ST segment is depressed and there is also the ST segment elevation in 2-3 AVF. When the ST segment elevation is in 2-3 AVF, you will definitely go for inferior wall MI. But plus, if the patient is also complaining of chest wall, but there is also ST segment depression in other leads and dominant R wave is also seen in a ECG paper, you will say that the patient is having posterior wall MI. Posterior wall MI. This posterior wall MI and inferior wall MI, in both conditions, you will notice that there is the ST segment depression in posterior wall MI and dominant R wave, and the patient also comes to you with the same complaints, and there will be also ECG change of ST segment elevation in 2-3 AVF. So both these conditions are justified, and there will be the artery involved, which is right coronary artery. In right, when this right coronary artery is blocked or there is an occlusion in right coronary artery, you will notice that there is the ST segment elevation in 2-3 AVF and the ST segment depression in other leads, or there will be the dominant R wave, which is actually showing the posterior wall MI. Because this artery is supplying the posterior wall and also the inferior wall, patient can comes to you with the complaint of chest wall, and there is also the artery involved, which is RCA. You can say that as this artery RCA is supplying both posterior wall and also inferior wall, that's why the patient can comes to you with both situation, that is ST segment elevation in 2-3 AVF, which will be showing the inferior wall MI, and ST segment depression plus dominant R wave, which is showing the posterior wall MI, because both have the blood supply from same artery, which is RCA. Then comes the hypokalemia. This is the condition in which there will be also ST segment depression, and acute pericarditis, which is the last condition which is showing here the ST segment depression. In acute pericarditis, you will notice that there is ST segment elevation on an ECG paper, and there will be also ST segment depression in AVR. The lead AVR will be showing ST segment depression, and obviously there will be PR depression noticed in acute pericarditis. So all these are the conditions which are showing the ST segment depression. So this was all about the ST segment depression. We have discussed the ST segment elevation in previous lecture. Go and watch my previous lecture for ST segment elevation. Today we have discussed the ST segment depression. Next we are going to discuss about the T wave of the ECG. So hope you like my video. Thank you very much for watching. I'll see you in my next video.